I want to show you what does it mean it's a hypercube. A cube, just a regular cube, from our three-dimensional reality, in a higher dimension, in the fourth and fifth dimension, automatically will extend on each side.
Right.
This is the hypercube. On each side is an extension.
Okay.
Now, this is a representation also material in our three-dimensional reality, the hypercube. But once you go in a higher dimension, fourth and fifth dimension, the time and space, it's not anymore material. Everything is energetic, it's fluidic. But as a representation, this is the representation of higher dimension. What I try to do also, to give movement to hypercube, not to create a static, because in a higher dimension, you don't have anything static. Everything is energetic, everything is in movement.
Right.
Even the idea of hypercube, it's a movement. It's not anymore the cube, what we know and what we see day by day. Now, let's go with our mind inside of this hypercube. If we will be situated on the first cube here, and if we will go in higher dimension, what we will see? We will see a cube up, right, left, and up. Now, let's go to this. We have on top a cube, left another cube, right another cube, down another cube, and we are situated in this cube. We are inside of higher dimension, in space and time. What is the meaning of music? In Genesis, it said, in the beginning was a word, was a sound.
Right.
What does it mean, a sound? For our three-dimensional existence, the most beautiful sound is the music. But finally, the music is a symbol of creation. The two hands, the conductor hands, the magical hands, which will conduct this music, which will conduct the creation itself, are popping out from a different dimension. On the middle, it's a human form. But this human form is not real, it's not material, it's just an idea, it's spiritual. This painting is a surreal form of a representation in our three-dimensional reality. It's like a dream. It's real and it's not real. It's a dream. It's kind of stage of dream, but very philosophical. I don't try to create in my work a different system of existence. I don't know. And especially a spiritual one where we are talking about energies. You cannot express energies in a picture. What I want to do with my work is just to open a door to our meditation, to our spiritual side. I never use static object in my artwork.
Okay.
Everything is about vibration. So from a static object, it gives a vibration, it gives a music
of move.
You have to move to give to alive the instrument. I'm just a human being. I don't think I create. Everything what I am able to do is to touch some fleshes from a higher dimension and to transport these fleshes in our reality. And the tool for this moment, for this three-dimensional existence, yes, I am the messenger. This is what I am feeling. I am not a creator, I am not a big artist. I'm just a tool. It's my kind of expression. It's what I am feeling, it's what I am. And think on this way. If you have the preparation and if this idea will be in the same resonance with your energy, you will be able through this painting to open the door, your doors, toward a higher dimension. There are several ways to explain our existence. Mathematics, physics, music, philosophical, even abstract color. My way to express the meaning of our existence and to jump in a higher dimension is this kind of art. This is the form of art what I feel. To liberate myself from the three-dimensional reality to a higher level of existence.